Everyone, it is now 1:05, and because we're recording this, we need to go ahead and get started. Good afternoon. I am Andrea Simmons. I am the program consultant for the interns and scholars, as well as the core development program. And today we're going to be talking about the internship program for 2019. Let's move through. I'd like to do some introductions, and I'll start off with Sindra, my colleague who I'll be taking over the internship program from. So Sindra, go first. All right, so now we're going to go around the room, and I'm asking that each of you give us your name, your division, your role, and whether or not you've hosted an intern here previously, what you enjoyed most, and what do you look forward to most in working with our interns. Who wants to start? Look, two hands. I like it. I'll just go ahead and start over here. Okay, but you have hosted one before? Okay.
Pizza. Mm-hmm. What do I enjoy most? What do I look forward to most working with the interns? So I just really look forward to passing on the knowledge that I've gained and kind of treating the interns like my mentors treat me, just to try to see if, you know, if I can help them make progress and be successful.
Okay. Thank you for that. And I'll start here. I saw your hand go up as well. Okay. All right, who's next? Okay.
I'm Scott Crafton with the Maintenance Division. I'm the MS4 Permit and Stormwater Management Program Manager there. We have treatment devices spread all over the road network that cleans up the water before it goes. I'm the guy who keeps track of all of those and makes sure it's working on. I've hosted internship 2 years now.
Okay.
And I've had great experiences and great interns. I think the thing I enjoy the most is seeing when the light bulbs go off, when they're exposed to new things and all of a sudden they get it and they see the connections and stuff. I also really enjoy nurturing more initiative among the interns to where, you know, we sort of point them in the right direction and give them a little bit of room to figure things out on their own. And usually that's done very successfully.
So. Awesome. Thank you for that. I know you just walked in. Name, division, role, and have you hosted an intern? And what do you enjoy most? And what are you looking forward to? Yes. Okay. Okay.
Providing them with different opportunities. And I think we can kind of
Awesome, awesome. Okay, perfect. This back table, Mr. Turner. Okay.
We have listed a term report that
And Chelsea. Thank you. You, sir.
My name is Deepak Koirala. I work for CAT Engineering Division. My role is heritage improvement project delivery. We have hosted the engineering past in 2 years now. Mm-hmm. And I also came from core development program in 2008. And I enjoy most sharing the knowledge and providing them the real world work experience to the users and giving feedback.
Perfect. Thank you for that. Next table.
My name is Dave. I'm sorry. Thank you. I'm the CM Construction Division in Nova District. And our division had it before interns, before I personally had it, but I had spring meets. And I enjoy explaining them and teaching them, passing them on to the experience.
All right. And last but not least.
Jim Gillespie. I work at the Research Council in Charlotte.
Okay.
Environmental planning and economics.
Okay.
As far as I know, this is the first time supervised an intern, although there are a lot of different categories.
Yes.
Worker bees.
Uh-huh. All right, so this is going to be your first time. So what are you looking most forward to since it's going to be your first? Well, that's the gist, okay. Perfect. So thank you guys for taking time and allowing me to get to know each of you. You just came. No, I had help. I got co-facilitators. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. Good afternoon. Sorry I'm late. We always have like 6 main priorities in our division. Mm-hmm. Katie can attest to that. And so it's great being here with you. And I'm George Gardner, Operations mm-hmm. Division. I work for Katie McCann.
No, he does not.
And, do whatever she says. And actually, I've been here for 24-something years mm-hmm. like that. And I have hosted several interns, scholars, CDPs over the years.
Okay.
They've all gone on to bigger and better things than I have.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very proud of that. That you can mentor these folks and they move on and are mm-hmm. successful, right?
Yes.
So what do I enjoy most? I think seeing them grow. Seeing the interns grow, you know? Hey, what's up, man? You know, and just seeing them move on to bigger and better things.
Awesome.
I think that's what we're all here for, to help them all move on and learn. Now, what I do look forward to is what Mr. Gillespie was saying about the workload. We have uh-huh. a tremendous workload in operations right now.
Mm-hmm.
And we need their help
Mm-hmm. We have two interns come soon, and the pay is going to be supervised with them directly, and we have a ton of work. So we really work. We give them professional work.
Uh huh.
You know, we've always done that.
Okay. I think that, and I'm going to use you guys as a little bit of a test pilot. I'm not sure if you all are aware, but the pipelines programs are under assessment right now. That includes the core development program, both interns and scholars. So I just want to get a pulse check in the room. I myself have only been with VDOT 11 months, so this has been a hat switching type of experience. So really, really, and looking to leverage the knowledge and the expertise here, especially around your experience across all three of the programs, but specifically today around the internship program. So thank you guys for sharing that. Any questions at this point? Awesome, awesome. All right, so we're going to do a little bit of work because I want to get you all thinking about where you're going with your interns. I know you have lots of work for them to do. So this is what the flow of today will look like. I know I gave you a 2-hour time span, but depending on your needs and desires and the conversation, that'll dictate the length of the experience. All right, so first up, what does a successful internship program look like? So based on my background and experience and then Sandra Yancey's background experience around internships, we've done some work to identify, we've attempted to identify the return on investment in our internship program, as well as conversion rates within our internship programs. So how many interns do we have within the organization over the full existence of the program, and how many of them actually transfer into wage or full-time positions? And unfortunately, to my knowledge, we're not tracking that holistically. So that's one of the things that we're really looking forward to and implementing within the program, because that is a true value add of the program. That's how you continue to get the funding and to get the resources. One of the big things that we really want to do is be able to distinguish the difference between summer work and internships. Summer work is just a person that's coming in, catching you up with the work. And in an internship program, it should be planned, structured, developmental focus. You're going to grow them, and then you can hopefully, the skills that you impart upon in those individuals will take them into the organization and make them competitive in some entry-level capacity. So that's the overall gist. So what I'd like you all to think about at your respective table teams, and you can feel free to join behind you or to the back of you, describe a positive experience that you had with a manager during your career. And what was the experience, and what did the manager do to impact your success? So chat at the table, and then I'll ask for an example from each one of you. I'll give you about 7 minutes to do that. Right. That's good that you got plenty of examples, though. That's awesome.
Mm. Oh, yes. That was, I had other internships, which turns out, so I found a background. Today it was just
Is the light on? It's on. Did everybody get to share at this table? Did everyone get a chance to share?
Yeah.
Awesome, awesome. Okay. Which one story would you like to share from the table, from your discussion? Anybody?
So our stories were so interesting that we just are
going to
consolidate.
Okay, I like that. I like that. Maximize efficiencies.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, his boss didn't do anything. He kind of gave him a workspace and told him no work. But we also, you know, had similar experiences with supportive managers.
Mm-hmm.
Had work plans for us and, you know, kind of hit the road with us to mm-hmm. teach us. And those things kind of helped to build a little bit more knowledge base in those particular areas. Even though sometimes the internships are not directly related to what you're going to be doing, it kind of has an opportunity to, you know, give you a little bit more base knowledge.
Build your professional skills holistically.
Yeah.
Well, and it was partly about planning, it was partly just about what they were doing.
Uh-huh. Exactly, exactly. All right, table in the back.
I think we can probably just summarize our story in 4 points.
Okay.
Each of us talked about we value, like, our managers being really flexible and, you know, providing an opportunity to work life balance as far as scheduling is concerned. Then we appreciated that giving us opportunities to grow within our role.
Mm-hmm.
We definitely talked about having opportunities for engagement and maybe like the networking events to help us be able to branch out and get more exposure in having those candid conversations or sort of polishing the network our elevators.
Okay. Thank you for that. That's perfect. And what about this table?
We talked about a lot of things that we already mentioned yesterday, uh-huh. but one thing that I know, I can't remember, Marcita mentioned that I really like. She was talking about how she was a supervisor who always was giving her like a higher level work, so that then she was always ready for the next, moving on, stuff like that. I thought that was cool. I hadn't really heard it phrased that way. And, you know, we also talked about building, as managers who help build confidence.
Did you say competence or confidence? Okay. Awesome, awesome. Thank you guys for sharing that. Because when we connect to our great experiences, we in turn want to deliver great experiences for those interns that we have that come on board with us. So now we're going to take a little look at the internship program overall. So it's a student or a trainee that's in the works or a trade environment. And they're coming to us to gain valuable work experience. So it's not only colleges and universities, but it's also community colleges. Is there another piece to it? And those that are transitioning out the military as well. So we have military coming in as well. And then we have all of these benefits. We're hopefully going to find our future employees, and you get to test drive the talent for a period of time and see where and how we could potentially use them in this environment. And then of course, the byproduct that we're all looking for is that increased productivity of your overall team, because you have those additional hands on task. And then it's a way in which you can give back to the community, because oftentimes, because of our outreach teams, we are attracting and connecting with individuals that may not have a natural access to to our organization. And doing so really ultimately results in VDOT being that employer of choice within the community in which we work and live, and could potentially serve as succession management in a future-focused type manner. And then it supports the students in developing those professional skills. And so we have to look at the full package of the individual. We want them to have that technical component, but we also want to guide and coach them as it's related to soft skills. I know pulling from Cindra, Cindra called an organization's front desk and the person said hello, and not like the organization or anything. It was literally like they were answering their home phone, and she looked at the phone to say, well, did I call a friend? So it's those little things that we don't always think about. And rather than getting frustrated, you know, take that as an opportunity, because every intern, when we orient with the intern, is that this is an opportunity to grow. You know, I think in our current culture, we all like to get excellence on our ratings, especially when it comes to performance evaluations, but we all have room to grow in truth. So if we set up an expectation that the job description is designed that this is the expectation, so you're going to meet the expectations. If you go above, I'm going to highlight that, but that should not always be the expectation, because you're growing, you're creating your foundation at this time. And then support student and their professional development, and enhancing their perspective around public service and transportation. And this is an opportunity that could lead to potentially either solid part-time work or wage work, or as well as full-time work. Do you have any questions around this overview? Perfect. All right, so our goal is to give meaningful employment where students can develop valuable work skills and enhance their knowledge around transportation and public service holistically. And this is an opportunity for them to give true hands-on work experience. So throw them in, get them involved, because watching others work, that's when you'll start to see people's head nods and their eyes close, and then they'll be looking for other opportunities. And then assistance in clarifying their career goals. Sometimes we don't know what we want to do, and this exposure really helps solidify us in one direction or the other. And then making sure that we're focusing on the behavioral competencies of a teammate that's already been established here within the organization. And again, about the full time, and then exposure to VDOT business needs. Any questions around this? Fantastic. This is again reiterating all of the things around work experience and public service, but also talking about the technical skills as well as the self-leadership components. So how do you advocate for yourself? How do you have a conversation? How do you manage your frustrations or irritations in the workplace? And those are conversations that we're going to be having with the interns during their orientation. And then again, one of our focuses from a recruitment component is a D&I perspective, which is one of the reasons why we go into the military community as well as community colleges in to include HBCUs and colleges, traditional colleges and universities. All right, so this is the flow of our schedule. This is the ideal flow of recruiting interns into the program. So the summer session begins in June. Our summer session starts on June 3rd. They'll be in orientation June 3rd and 4th, and they'll be coming to your respective teams on June 5th. In July, we should receive intern requests. We are looking to revamp this and what this looks like, so you'll be planning on the front end for the next year, what kind of work you'll be giving them, just trying to think about it, because we want to recruit in a more targeted manner. This year, you probably didn't feel it, but the process that we went through was a little laborious, to say the least. So we're really trying to have it be a little more succinct, streamlined, and really, really from the offset when Sindra and her team, I guess, and myself included, goes out to engage with students, we know what we're looking for because we have your request in hand. So it's August and September when we're engaging with students, we're like, the positions are posted, or give me your information so we can do it over a protracted period of time, and just trying to make it a little more seamless. And then in August, the summer session ends. So your intern will be leaving you anytime between mid-August to late August timeframe, because classes kick up again around the 15th to 20th. So plan your schedules accordingly in that regard. Please.
Also, I would say as you all have like your first meeting with your intern when they first get here, go ahead and start talking about, you know, well, do you know when your classes start back up? Maybe on the 17th, they may need to leave on the 1st because they may have family vacations that they're trying to get in with their family. So make sure you go ahead and set that ahead of time so you can also, that'll help you with your project planning as well to know when to start wrapping everything up. Waiting till the end.
Any questions around that? And everyone knows that we do both mid and end of experience evaluations on the interns. And so the hope with the new process would be that we'll have their roles either posted online or we'll be highly engaged with every college doing VDOT specific recruiting events, tapping into the existing recruiting events, trying to get out early as possible. And I know because we're a public sector organization, we're not really competitive with the private industry, but on average, private industry has this locked down very early. And then at the end of the experience, every intern has an actual job offer in hand. So we want to kind of mirror that to the best we can as a state organization. So that's a part of the reason and the rationale behind some of the rigor we're putting in. And making sure that we have the intern requests posted. In September and October, that's when our high recruiting season begins. And what we'll be probably looking to do is to tap you, because you know what it is that you're looking for. You are your designee, what you're looking for. So come out with us and talk to the interns and identify them. Because this is a wage opportunity, we can identify and run them through their process and potentially make offers, and you can have it done as early as September, October for the next year. And that just feels a little more manageable, especially from a program perspective and hopefully from a intern manager perspective as well.
But that will mean just start thinking ahead of time of what may be coming down the pipeline, and then that will assist with job description creation, that will assist with the job posting, and making sure we are targeting for those students that would fulfill your need.
Any questions to this point? I know it's a lot of information, but to many of you, because you've already had interns, it seems familiar. Yes.
I have a question. Trigger
to start thinking, or that these
hard copy or soft? Would you prefer email alerts?
Or I think everybody's different. But
right. I mean,
it's not on my calendar. A lot of times, out of sight, out of mind. Until
so you like that alert potentially in your automated calendar. I'm flexible. We have it both ways. We have it hard copy and we populate it into the system. If this is something that you'd like to have, these dates, yeah, saying, hey, this is what's going on now, this is what's going on now, we can certainly make sure that you have it. The challenge is with the potential changes with the program, but this will go on my list of what we'd like to see in the future iteration of the program. So thank you for surfacing that.
Yeah. At least to
the
DA.
Mm-hmm.
Reactive.
Yes, that proactivity is our friend. Okay, so in November, we're anticipating that the roles will, all of the positions will close. November, December, we begin the screening and the interviewing, and that's for things that haven't been filled during the recruitment cycle. So if you're going to the career fairs, and we're going to the career fairs knowing what it is that you're looking for, this is only for the ones that we have not found that we would be screening for. And then the fall session for college actually begins in the November to December timeframe. Ends. And in December, the winter session begins. So we do have some divisions that elect to have interns. And the reason why this is in there is that some divisions and districts do elect to have their interns year round. So not only the 8 weeks during the summer, but they'll have them during the fall, the winter session, and the spring session. The big difference is, Sandra, fall and spring are a max of 20 hours.
Right. So that's why, so that is our way of also making sure that they don't get so consumed with VDOT work that they neglect their academic responsibilities. So we do have to put a cap on that, just to ensure that we create that balance. But when they're on break, winter break, the winter break in the summer, so anytime they're not in school, they can do essentially 40 hours. But once they're in school, they are limited to that 20 hours max. And that 20 hours, 10 of it, workforce development pays for, 10 of it, your department pays for.
Wait, about that 10, what was that?
You're like, wait a minute. So, during the fall season and the spring season, students can work a maximum of 20 hours per week. 10 hours, workforce development will cover, and 10 hours, the department has to cover. So that first 10 hours, your intern will put in the codes that are related to workforce development. And then the next 10, you all will have to provide them with whatever code within your department it needs to go to. So we split it, essentially. We're splitting that. And like I said, the only reason that they can work that is if they have performed well. And that, which means you have to do those evaluations. We have to see that they perform well and that they're even eligible. Some students can do it because they go to school close to wherever you all work, but those that, you know, can't, because it's just too far, not every student will have the opportunity.
You had a question?
Well, just a comment to elaborate on that from my own experience.
Mm-hmm.
The older students, you know, since my insurance pastor is a graduate student,
mm-hmm,
tend to have a pretty good sense of how much of that 20 hours they can actually manage.
Mm-hmm.
And it may vary over the course of the session.
Right.
Beginning of the session,
mm-hmm,
get to the middle of the end when the work starts loading up the reports and papers and things, then the hours start to drop off. So it's useful to be aware of that if you haven't had one from before.
Yeah.
Because we are managing the program criteria for the intern is definitely GPA weighted as well. And we as an organization is very generous. We actually allow people a period of time to get things up to par, and if the world were mine, I come out of the academic environment and I am passionate. I'm an academician at my core, and a trainer is my secondary. So I definitely would be like, oh, fell below. I need you to focus on your studies because, you know, jobs are always going to be there. You're going to have the rest of your life to work. And so, because I'm at VDOT, I support giving another chance, but when that chance is not leveraged and the GPA continues to decline, we have no other choice but to prioritize the grades for them by saying, go focus on your education. VDOT's gonna be here. Okay, January, internship offers, perfect world. We want to know every one of our interns and where they're going and what they're going to be doing by January. Because I don't know if anybody in this room had this experience, but there was a significant number of requests for interns. And because the schedule that we were on, due to a number of reasons, multifaceted, we were not able to fulfill every order. And this is one of the reasons why we really need to be early in the process so that we can get our first picks and not have to continue to dive down. So we want to have those internship offers in January. And then we move to February. For those of you that have existing interns, if you want to have them on deck for those 20 hours in the spring, that begins in February. And we, on the program management side, will be finalizing the placement. So we have to do offer letters, and we have to do background checks and DMV checks. So this is more information for the program rather than for you as the intern manager. And then our goal will be moving forward, this intern manager training will occur in April. And because this is a fairly rigorous schedule, what I would anticipate doing is moving the training across regions instead of trying to have everyone come to central office. But as I shared, I think at the onset, I'm doing CDP interns and scholars. So building a lot of character. Does anyone have any questions around this program cycle? Any recommendations for modifications or changes? Anything like that? Perfect. All right, so toolkits and expectations. All right, let me go back. I have some documents here that I will push to you electronically, and they will be on the internship shared site. So the first document in the packet that you will get will be the internship project plan. This is where you're going to go and plan what it is that you're going to have your interns doing. The other document is reminding you about the performance evaluation at mid and at the end. And the last document is the on-site manager checklist, those things that you should be doing in preparation for your interns. What's in it for you? I think you guys did a great job illuminating what you're excited about and what's going to actually be the benefit. They're going to be happy to take on any project or any task or work that you throw at them. They want that challenge. They want that stretch opportunity to actually occur. That wasn't me. They want that actual stretch opportunity, so allow them that opportunity to do that. And then it's a way in which you're giving back to the career and their professionals and the knowledge, everything that you mentioned to them, the schoolwork, their careers, and it can impact them for generations and impact their family. And then what does success look like? Assigning the work, which is what we just talked about, having the subject matter expert that contributes to the success of the intern's development, demonstrate proper professional conduct. we have high expectations of the interns, and we will be communicating that in the internship, and we want you to partner with us in maintaining that high expectation. Because if they do subsequently become a VDOT employee, and we've allowed them to do whatever, whenever, they're gonna think that that can transfer into permanent employee. So we really want to hold them to the teammate standard that we hold to everyone else on our teams. Questions here? Perfect. And we would like you all to be actively involved, making sure that you're available to not only teach, but answer the questions that they have, and maintain a strong relationship with myself as the program consultant, as well as with your HRC, our HR human resources consultant or manager, as you need to. We've already talked about the midterm evaluation and the final evaluations, and making sure that you surface and address all behavioral concerns and document and make sure that that appears on the mid and the end of term evaluations, because that's a part of the determining factor in addition to the GPA as to whether or not those individuals can return to VDOT for an internship experience.
Improve. That's the time that they need to know. At the end is not the time to document that on their evaluation, and you have not had that conversation because they haven't had the opportunity to correct whatever is going on. So please make sure that you do that mid, and even just conversations along the way before the mid evaluation, to give them that chance to steer them back on the right track.
Yes, sir.
When is midsummer?
They come on board with you June 5.
So it's going to be early third week in July.
July, yeah, first, second week in July, because they can be gone by mid-August from your team.
But you'll get a reminder.
All right, yeah, that's
yeah. And it's still a ballpark, because it depends on your respective interns how long they plan on staying. So,
if the intern's going to bug out a little earlier in August,
right?
The mid-summer
eval could be earlier. Yes, indeed. And we're going to talk about the approve the intern's timesheet and Cardinal. That is crucial. And you are that source to approve, check, all of it. Again, I'm 11 months in. I just learned not to use my cheat sheet to put my own time in. So I'm really relying heavily on you to support that intern, that scholar, in the Cardinal process. And we will be going over the Cardinal. Once everyone's on board, I'm supposed to push the Cardinal training to every intern for them to actually go through, because we're working on granting them access now.
Send an email to Andrea to say, I am going to be out of the office, but this person did 35 hours this week and is approved for payment. Then we can work with payroll to still make sure that they get paid on time. That's one thing that we don't want them to go back to school to say is, well, my timesheet was always late. I never got paid on time. That's a part of branding that we don't want to go back to campus. But make sure you plan accordingly, and you remember that, oh, I'm going on vacation, timesheets are due, please. And payroll does help us out a great deal. I think they do more than they probably need to. But if we can do our part ahead of time, that'll eliminate, you know, more that they have to do for us.
Chelsea?
Is that the same for the VSU interns?
No.
No. Okay. They're not paid through us.
Okay. Yeah. So you won't have Cardinal at all.
Last year, like, there was a timesheet component, so like I had to fill out a spreadsheet.
Right, that'll probably still be a requirement, but not inside of our Cardinal system. Any other questions? Awesome, awesome. And we do have meet with the intern at least weekly to provide performance feedback. Any issues, this is a great time to address it. And we will be partnering with you in the intern orientation to ensure that they should expect developmental conversations all along the way, because this is a developmental program. Yes, sir.
I don't know whether this is useful for others, but with my interns, basically, I had them doing a weekly report to me from their assigned work. What did they get accomplished that week?
Okay.
And you know, were they hung up on anything that they needed help with? Mm-hmm. Did they have any questions? And I always tell them I'm always available for questions.
Right.
Ask or whatever. But that, you know, they would get into the routine,
mm-hmm.
basically. And I also challenged them to try to figure things out on their own. If they had
an
unresolved issue, when they came to talk about it, at least bring some suggestions with them about how they might. And if I have a chance to say, well, that's a really great idea, do that, then they figure it out on their own. That's a confidence build.
Yeah, I think that's a great tip, because sometimes they can get into routine just coming straight to you with a question. So we kind of, at least if they can't find it, at least be able to show that I did go through the steps to try to find it on my own. And so that's a great learning. I think that's a learning. I wish some other times would say.
That, and I think the weekly report, I put it down in the notes so that I know you have a form, but if that's going to be helpful holistically, it's something that we can set as an expectation for an intern. Because what it's also doing for them is helping them build their resume as well. So you're tracking what you're doing, what your successes have been from week to week, and that can help build your resume, build their resume. All right, so we've already talked about this a little bit, and I'm confident that we each are doing it, maintaining open communications, and that's with the intern, with your HR team, with me as the program consultant, making sure that things that need to be addressed, you're supported from operations to be able to support you in that, coaching opportunities, mentoring opportunities, making sure that they have access to the resources, so knowing who the moving parts are, and then we'll definitely be supporting you in that regard. Managing expectations around the midpoint and the endpoint of the evaluation cycle, and then of course reinforcing that whole safety component, which is our number one priority. And then last but not least, Cardinal, which is how they get paid. And so you do not have a flash drive, but I have given you a touch of those documents, and these documents are actually loaded onto the internship shared site so that you can pull down the project template, which I've already given you a hard copy of. The mid and the end of summer evaluation is the exact same document, just receiving them at different times. The learning competencies is already on the site. The summer internship calendar was just completed, and I think Sandra pushed it out to you. No, she probably sent you the list of all of the interns. So the calendar will update and get that out there to you. And then we'll make sure that we introduce the interns to Inside VDOT during their orientation as well. All right, so if you guys can, I don't know that I want to use the full 30 minutes, but I'll leave it up to you. On that document that you all have, begin jotting down what it is that you'll be planning for your intern as far as their projects and their assignments when they come to your team. How many of you already have your project plans already drafted? Yes, I mean, I want the whole class to be like this every time. So I'm glad I got you all on video with all hands raised. me saying that all hands are raised is only watching me. So because you know that this is a task, we will not take the 30 minutes to do this, but I want you to know that this is pivotal to the success of your program. And this document will also be a great document to modify and utilize for the recruitment process. Remember, we talked about having something so we can go out and capture the interns that you want for the next recruiting cycle. This is the document that you would want to use. Tell me what you're looking for, what kind of background, what kind of work you're looking for, so that when we're talking with students, we're saying we have a team that's looking for someone that's doing this, and they're like, that's me, so that we can more directly match up what it is that you're looking for in your internship program. Any questions around the project plan? Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
In the sense of giving them an idea of the scope of opportunity there is.
Mm-hmm.
My interns are right now, at least last year and this year, working on GIS kinds of activities, mapping and our inspection application, and helping us fill in unfilled information and that kind of thing. But when I get engineering students in here doing that kind of work, I want them to know that we've got a structure section. As structural engineers, we have a hydraulic section that does drainage design. We've got road planners, transportation planners, and we've got at Virginia Tech, they've got a whole experimental road. And materials division. And so, as schedules allow, we try to get these kids out on kind of field trips. I don't know whether that's something that you all also coordinate, and I don't want to stumble over something that's already
No, I love that you're taking the lead on that. No, we do not have a component, because the reason why we bring everyone on the front end of the internship experience is because we don't bring them back again. Many of our private industry colleagues do bring them midpoint and at the end point, like a rally of some sorts, but resources around that I don't believe are available within the agency.
In a van that you're going down, and you would like to open that, or any of you, and you want to open that seat up to another intern, let us know that you're going to be going, or let Andrea know where you will be.
She said it right the first time. You all heard it. You're my witness.
Let us know that you have maybe a couple of seats, and we can put the feelers out to see who we can stick in there, because it's great for them to learn, yes, their team, but it's great to for them to see, why they should be at VDOT in the first place. And so expanding their knowledge may also help them figure out, I really want to learn more about this. Or, I really want to shadow someone or have a conversation or whatever that may be. That's a part of their development while they're here.
We had an engineering student from VDOT last summer that was showing me, who had never done GIS before. And we taught her how to do some very fundamental GIS work. When she went back to school, she actually got a job at the university part-time.
See?
Doing GIS work.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's awesome. They really are. And I think the exposure to, because VDOT is such a large agency and there's so many opportunities all across the state, like there's over 600 job classifications within the organization. And to know that there's so much to do, one of the big benefits that I had coming into the organization was going out and visiting other districts. Now, that slowed down significantly. However, it equipped me with knowledge and insight that I would not have had I remained between the first floor in human resources and the 13th floor in the annex building. And so we were at a veterans event last week, and the girl was complaining about the tunnel in Hampton Roads. And so when I did my tour in Hampton Roads, and what's fascinating to me about Hampton Roads is bridges, roads, ferries, and tunnels. I didn't even know we had a ferry system until I went there. I was like, oh, yeah, never knew it. So And so, right. And so I went on the tunnels tour. Fascinating. And so I was able to squelch her frustration with the tunnel. I was like, do you know that when an accident occurs in a tunnel, there's a system that's sucking out dirty air and pushing in clean air, and the reaction time, you know, pushes back the traffic so far. I was like, so you should be thankful that you weren't trapped in the tunnel. So you gotta, it's about perspective. So really having that knowledge is power. And what we're doing here really is early in the infancy of our interns' lives. So we have the opportunity to really provide a great experience on a positive side, because you know, bad word of mouth travels it's quick and thick. You know, it goes really, really fast. So we really want to make sure that we are creating a dynamic experience in which people can go back and do much of the campaigning for us. So when we go to the colleges and universities, people are seeking us out rather than us having to pitch. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Katie and I plan to bring some of our interns, or both of them probably, out on into the districts on some real life projects.
Mm-hmm.
Is that something that you care to know about when we do it?
I care more that they document it as part of their experience. How I would care more is if you were asking that we pay for something, because I'm only saying this because it just happened. Someone wants to go for, you know, because, and I'm, again, I'm new. I'm like, sure, we'll pay for it. exactly. And so when it comes to interns, we do not provide, other than they're coming here for the intern orientation, we do not provide housing, per diem, or anything like that. So no. Yeah. So have fun with them and make sure that they document it.
And a great way to document that is that I think it's great for interns to do like an end of summer presentation of some sort where they can showcase to your team their experience, because they're not going to work with everybody on your team.
Right.
So, you know, that's a chance for them to shine and showcase their experience and talk about what they learned and maybe how they'll be able to apply it when they go back to school. Mm-hmm. I think that's a great way for them to incorporate all of the additional things that enhance their experience. And that's something that even you can keep to show history and project examples of what they did. But you know, if you do that, send us
share the information with us.
Showcase, and I know for me, that probably would be a great learning tool for me when I'm on campus and it's time for us to recruit for you again in case you can't be there. I can say, well, these are the type of projects that they offer. These are examples of what an intern could work on. So that's a learning resource for me too. So why not let them shine, invite your leadership and show that. I think last year, someone did get a job offer because a leader was in the room while they presented, and somebody else was in the room while they presented, and they were able to really see all of the wealth of knowledge and work that's been poured into them.
And that's a part of the return on investment that we're looking for. And we're not cataloging it. We're not housing it. We're not harnessing it. So the work that you do with your individual or groups of interns really will then begin to demonstrate value for the program so that it can be sustained on an ongoing basis. You know, when budget cuts come, you know, you want to be able to demonstrate that here's where the value is being added from this perspective. Any other questions in this regard? Thank you, guys. That was great discussion. All right, mentors. How many of you that get interns assign a mentor? Chelsea, you do? Okay, so assign a mentor for your interns, or do you serve in that capacity as the manager? You serve in, okay, so all of this applies to you. And then Chelsea, your mentor. So typically, normally, the mentor is not their manager. That's a person that they can go to, use them as a sounding board, share their career path experiences. And these, again, are things that you can do. Learn more about the student, have informal check-ins, take them to presentations, coach them, take them to meetings, answer questions, all of this stuff, and being true to themselves and help them practice for their final presentation. This is assuming that you all do take the final presentation component. So this is what a mentor is doing. They're just serving there. That might be that person that they go to prior to coming to you to ask that question so that they're learning how to fish. Questions around the mentor piece?
And that mentor, if you decide So whether it's VDOT related, professional related, as you get to know your student, you'll be able to figure out what they need. And so I would just say keep that in mind as you act in this position or you assign someone, but just make sure it's that person that you essentially are trusting, you know, your
intern
with.
Mm-hmm. So I worked on construction a few years back, and started, where we had like area construction engineers in Vancouver, starting out the civil engineers.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They loved that, even though they reported to us.
Yeah.
And they really learned a lot.
And it's my understanding there's a number of efforts enterprise-wide around a mentorship program. So hopefully all components of mentors and mentorship will be coming up under one umbrella for us to leverage across the full trajectory of the agency.
And this could be a professional development opportunity for the person you select to be the mentor. So maybe it's something that you want to, you know,
It's a stretch opportunity, you know, a lifelong learning component for that individual as well. All right, so the types of mentors. So we talked a little bit about it, the career guide, guidance, counseling, you know, just driving them from an academic perspective. And then information resource. Who do you ask these questions to? Well, I have one person on my team that I call Obi-Wan, and they serve as my know-all. And when they don't know, I was like, what? So I was like, I'm going to take away the Obi part. And then friends. So social, because, you know, when you're new to the team, you eating lunch by yourself, you feel very trapped and isolated. So just thinking about being new. And then an intellectual guide, making sure that they collaborate on projects and learn how to receive critical feedback, because that is a skill to learn how to receive and internalize developmental feedback. Program guidelines and expectations. So as the program consultant, I'm a resource to both you and the interns. I provide managerial and supportive services, perform activities around program participation, and all the logistics related to coming to the interns coming on board. And then seasonal work assignments, program orientation. So all of the logistics components is really what my role is. And then capturing that information, making sure that I get the, what do you call those things? Transcripts, making sure I check the transcripts, making sure I get the mid and the end of term, end of experience evaluations, all of that administrative task stuff, as well as helping grow them professionally. So when we have the students here on June 3rd and 4th, they're going to go through the program orientation. They're going to have a lunch. There's going to be a panel that they can add, do a Q&A with, and then we're going to do some professional development components with them, chiefly around their resume building, social media, professionalism in the workplace, just to make sure that you're getting the appropriate work individual in your within your teams. This presentation has already been turned into a PDF, and I will push this to you as well as post it on our shared site for internships so that you can have it at your fingertips in a fuller scale than that the 3-slide version. Partners and best practices. Cardinal. Again, because this is around pay for the intern, making sure that their time and attendance is done. And we're not addressing stipends because we have only a few, maybe what, 7 or 8 scholars on our books right now. And so that's, again, a piece that the program manages, and that won't be a part for you. Then the SARA request. What did you want to say about that?
So the SARA request, they have already been
Let's see. I have another slide that gives more detail around each one of the human resources managers as well as the DLMs. There was no place that I could find all of the safety managers and going out and like for central office and all the districts. So this was a previous presentation. And then the safety guidelines, we do have a safety presenter, don't we? So we will have an hour presentation for them around safety as well.
Remind me again, when they get their safety equipment, are y'all paying for that?
Safety PPE?
PPE, I think we do.
Yeah, to my knowledge, I mean, that's what I've done, like the safety boots and... Right, exactly, and apparently I have a budget code to go with it. let's see. Ensure that you're approving the intern's time. Whoever will approve the time will be listed as the manager. And so if it's not you, you have to let us know who your designee is so that we can ensure that that's in the system. The cost code is remaining the same. And then the intern pay calendar, I do have that. So the 2019 pay calendars are here.
And most of the time, I think payroll will send out a reminder saying
they do, every 2 weeks.
The period is getting ready to close, so you should get a reminder.
Yes. And if they weren't, they will now.
We'll also upload them on
our shared drive. So we'll be introducing them to that as well. And I know we keep mentioning the shared drive. If everyone's familiar with where the intern shared page is.
So it's a SharePoint site or it's a shared drive?
SharePoint site. Yes, sir.
Unpaid
leave, yeah.
Unpaid leave. They don't accumulate vacation. No. And we can send, when the link and the documents get sent out, we can provide a link to SharePoint.
Yes. So I think the conversation around vacation, because it will be unpaid and you all are planning your schedules, should be had on as close to day one as possible so that you'll know. And then if you have any issues, please feel free to reach out to me. And Sandra, what did you want to say about inside v.fiscal? What's, I don't even know what that is. No, okay. I honestly don't have any information about that. All right, so I did have an opportunity, and this is why you have the full presentation will be on the site so you can see all the names. So I have listed all of the full HR team, as well as the HRM for every district, as well as the team here in central office. And then here is the training, the district and division learning managers. So Richard Allard is the central office learning manager, and then each one of the district's learning managers. And then the safety team, this is the one I told you, not housed anywhere succinctly. So if you need that, I'm certain I can get that information for you, but it was not readily available at my fingertips and all of the places that I searched. And then this is a message from our commissioner around our safety. And safety's not silent, speak up. We should all know this verbatim by now, right?
Sure.
Yep. And then safety equipment. That was a question that was asked. Require protective equipment when working in the field. So the hard hat, the high visibility vest, and the steel-toed boots. Reimbursed up to $160. So when that occurs, I do have to process that because I think it's a separate budget code. And so that, depending on the nature of the work, may include safety glasses, goggles, gloves, protection for hearing, all of that. And so again, your safety manager within the district or division or the central office safety manager will be your point of contact for that. That's the end of the presentation. What questions or concerns do you have at this point? Yes, sir. Yes.
Workforce takes care of office and all the core stuff, you know, with OEP, upgrader, and that kind of stuff. If we need them to have access to GIS software or some with MicroStation or something like that, usually the divisions are taking care of those requests.
Yeah.
That was the perfect answer. yes, sir, you had a question. Yes, we have placed the order for the assets for the laptops. So as how what's our setup?
So as of right now, when they come in on orientation, those that are under central office will get their laptops on day one. Anyone that's not under central office will get their laptops once they get back to their district on the 5th. So our goal is that IT will come down on the 3rd. Just like we're getting their badges done, they'll get their laptop assigned. Our goal then is also to go ahead and get them validated before they get to you all. So you won't have to worry about that. So once they get to you, all they got to do is log in, check email, do whatever training modules that have been pushed to them, and can just start.
Okay.
So we'll take care of that.
One moment, Nick. Chelsea.
Above and beyond the package that we provide.
And the packages you provide are basic MS project, right?
Yeah.
I mean, basic MS office.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
We have one intern who's returning, so she's obviously not going to orientation. How do we get her left?
She will be at
She's
going to
be at orientation.
She's not.
Oh, she's not coming. That's right.
So, we will get it to you.
Good.
Yes. With her badge.
That's right.
Yeah,
she would just go through getting a new badge, right?
Yes. Her first day, she's gonna have to go to badging to take her picture, so I won't be able to get that on the 3rd.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
So, you said the returning and
they will, but
she had a special, yeah.
So, everybody will go through orientation unless they have a special situation and they will start a little bit.
And so, our schedule is that the new interns will come in. They're going to have a customized new employee orientation in the auditorium moving through the rotations. Then, at lunchtime, the returning and new will have lunch together, and then we will begin the program overview and professional development and all of that. Did you have a follow up? Okay.
What time do they actually start?
Newbies.
Is it?
They have to be here between 9:30 and 10.
9:30, yes.
Starts at 10. Returners have to be here between 11:30 and 12 and time for lunch.
So the newbies will be kind of running around
in the hallway.
Because I like to come down and find my interns.
Oh, yeah.
Myself.
Oh, very nice.
Definitely.
Very nice.
So they should probably more than likely be hanging out in the hallway as of 9:30.
Yeah, checking in at the security desk, and we'll try to usher them to the auditorium, which is where the lion's share of everything will be occurring. Any other questions, concerns?
I wanted to just throw out some things that when you reach out to your student, some things that you can reinforce in conversation. So it could be, so we're going to talk about dress attire, but if you all have something on your team that you do is special to your team on Thursdays or anything like that, please let them know that information versus them coming to work and everybody's casual and they're in their suits. I don't think they'll be doing suits, but you don't want them to feel like the outcast. Reinforce hours. So if your team is 7:30 to 4:30 or 8:30 to 5, whatever that is, make sure that they are aware of that as well. And one thing I would also say to do in your first meeting with them, discuss with them how your communication style. do you prefer, do you chat? Some people do not chat.
And, you know, the instant message or the Google chats, yeah.
Chats, I mean, our young folks, they love to chat and text and all of that. If you don't do that, you know, have that conversation with them, or if you prefer that they come to your desk or send an email or whatever your response time is, kind of let them know what your process is, and you can get to learn their process as well. So, and anything that falls along those lines, if you want them to schedule one-on-one, put that accountability on them to put it on your calendar. That's a great task for them. Schedule it on Mondays every 2 weeks at 3 o'clock. Let them own that piece of their learning. And anything else that you can think of that will just make them feel welcomed, and that they're going to have a great process here, a great experience here, I would say go for it. And if you need support, just let us know.
Thank you so much for your time and attention. Have a great rest of the day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, can you